Namaste one and all. Welcome to the second episode of my visual story series. In the previous episode, we have seen the difference between Bani, school and style. We have portrayed Bani as a big tree and its branches as various schools, right? Now the questions are, what are the essential requirements for a Bani? How many Banis are there in Mridangam playing and which all are they? Can someone create a new Bani? Lot of questions. Let us try to find answers. First question is, what are the essential requirements for a Bani? Well, there shall be multiple schools under a Bani, like multiple branches in a tree, and multiple followers or disciples like multiple leaves in the branches of a tree. Further, a Bani needs to have some kind of uniqueness, like defined playing methodologies, standard characteristics, clear patterns, fingering techniques, etc. Now, how many Banis are there in Mridangam playing and which all are they? Well, it is almost impossible for me to list down all Banis prevailing from the past, as there are no written sources for this. But I can definitely name the two popular Banis to which we can positively map almost all masters in one way or the other. Yes, in this episode, we will try to highlight the pioneers and torchbearers of the two popular Banis, and then we will list down the major schools under them. Yes, the two popular Banis, Thanjavur Bani and Pudukkottai Bani. Before going to Thanjavur and Pudukkottai Banis, we need to have a starting point from where the Mridangam playing started, right? From available sources, Thanjavur Narayanasami Appa, who lived in the 19th century, can be considered as the originator of modern Mridangam playing. Another senior Vidwan in the past who influenced many was Kumbakonam Azhaganambi Pillai. Let us understand a little bit more about Narayanasami Appa and Azhaganambi Pillai. Thanjavur Narayanasami Appa, who lived in the 19th century, is considered as the originator of modern Mridangam playing, the father of modern day Mridangam playing. He was basically a Marathi who settled in Thanjavur and was originally known as Nana Sama Rao. He learned Mridangam from Vidwan Shivaswami Appa. He was a well-known vocalist too. He used to conduct bhajans, singing and simultaneously playing the Mridangam. He was a musician in the Darbar of King Sarfoji in Thanjavur. Thanjavur Ramdas Rao was one among the prime disciples of him. Thanjavur Ramdas Rao was the guru of Maestro Madras A. Kannan, who passed away last year. Azhaganambi Pillai was born at Srirangam in a musical family and brought up at Kumbakonam. He was trained by his uncles Swaminatha Pillai and Venga Pillai. His two prime disciples are Chidambaram B. Nagaraja Iyer and Kumbakonam M. Rajappa Iyer. Those days there were other Vidwans also, Daswami, Thanjavur Pakkiri Pillai, Jutka Vandi Babu, among many others. The playing methodology of Narayanasami Appa evolved as a big tree. Getting influenced by this big tree and several years of collaboration and exchange of ideas, two big Banis, big trees, evolved. These are the Thanjavur Bani and Pudukkottai Bani. Let us first understand about the origin of Thanjavur Bani. Thanjavur Vaidyanatha Iyer is considered as the founder and torchbearer of Thanjavur Bani. He was born in Vaiyacheri near Thanjavur, Tamil Nadu in 1897. He learned Mridangam from Thanjavur Dos Swamigal, Kannusami Nattuvanar and K. Ponnaiya Pillai. He was highly influenced by the playing of Thanjavur Narayanasami Appa. He was popularly known as Vaitha Anna. Vaitha is a short form for Vaidyanatha and Anna means elder brother. It is interesting to note that he served in the state broadcasting station in Trivandrum, Kerala. His disciples, all-time great Palakkad T.S. Maniyar, living legend Dr. T.K. Murthy, Thambusami, who is a brother of T.M. Thyagarajan, T. TR Harihara Sharma, father of Master Biku Vinayakram, Mangudi R. Doreraja Iyer, Vilvadri Iyer, Krishnamurthy Rao, and legendary Master Umayalpuram K. Shivaravan, among many others. He passed away on 13th April 1947. Now, let us understand the origin of Pudukkottai Bani. Pudukkottai Manpundiya Pillai is considered as the founder and torchbearer of Pudukkottai Bani. He was born on 14th December 1859. He is a disciple of Tavil Vidwan Tirugokarnam Mariyappa Pillai or Mariyappa Tavilkar. It was Manpundiya Pillai who invented Kanjira, and there is a story behind it. Even before learning from his guru, Manpundiya Pillai was adept at playing an instrument called dep, a big circular tambourine-like instrument which was a very popular instrument at that time used in folk dance performances. Under the rigorous training by his guru, he developed the grammar of rhythm. During training sessions, he used to surprise his guru by replicating all the tavil patterns in this instrument. The dep being a big instrument, his guru suggested him to reduce the size of dep, also to suit the sound and nada required for Carnatic music. Manpundiya Pillai worked on the instrument and reduced the size of the instrument. He used jackwood for the outer ring and used the skin of monitor lizard for the covering. This predominantly bass percussion instrument came to be called Kanjira, and the credit for introducing this to the mainstream Carnatic music goes to Manpundiya Pillai. Those days, approval of any new percussion instrument or a new lay vidwan has to be done by Mahavidwan Narayana Sami Appa, who lived in Thanjavur. Someone suggested Manpundiya Pillai to play this instrument before Narayana Sami Appa. After reaching Appa's residence, he showed his instrument and requested for his approval. The next day for the bhajane, Appa started playing Mridangam and asked Pillai to accompany on Kanjira. Pillai was able to replicate almost all phrases played by Appa. After the bhajane, they played a percussion duet together. Appa was highly impressed by Pillai's playing. After Narayana Sami Appa's approval, Manpundiya Pillai wrote the Carnatic music field as a giant, and that was the beginning of Pudukkottai Bani. Now, the disciples of Manpundiya Pillai: all-time great Pudukkottai Dakshinamurthy Pillai, Palani Muthaiya Pillai, who is the father of Mahavidwan Palani Subramanyam Pillai, Ramanathapuram Chitsabai Servai, who is the father of Mahavidwan C.S. Murugabhupathi, Sedu Zamindar, Kuneri Rajapuram Vaidyanatha Iyer, who was a vocalist, Kanadukatha Mariyappa Iyer, Tiruchandur Ramayya Pillai, Shankaradas Swamigal, among many others. Manpundiya Pillai passed away on 17th January 1922. Now, let us take a look at the major schools under Thanjavur Bani. There are two major schools under Thanjavur Bani: the Palkad Maniyar School and Dr. T.K. Murthy School. Now, the major schools under Pudukkottai Bani. Under Pudukkottai Bani, there are three major schools: the Pudukkottai Dakshinamurthy Pillai School, Palani Muthaiya Pillai School, Ramanathapuram Chitsabai Servai School. We are done with the two popular Banis and the major schools under them. How about the styles then? As we have seen in the previous episode, leading masters under a particular school gets influenced by other schools, develops their own playing methodology, which would result in a new style. Sometimes it happens that the style created emerges as a tree itself, a Bani itself, because of its uniqueness and also because of the gravity and significance of branches and leaves in the tree. Let me share two examples which I believe the style got emerged as a Bani. As we have seen earlier, under Thanjavur Bani, there are two major schools. While Dr. T.K. Murthy continued the great traditional Thanjavur Bani as it is, Palghat Maniyar got highly influenced by the Pudukkottai Bani, especially by Dakshinamurthy Pillai. In fact, Palghat Maniyar considered Dakshinamurthy Pillai as his sagacious mentor, Manasa Guru. Thus, the style adopted by Palghat Maniyar emerged as a Bani with lot of branches and leaves. Similarly, the style adopted by Guru Karaikudi R. Mani. He was trained first by Karaikudi Rengu Ayyangar under Pudukkottai Bani and later by T.R. Harihara Sharma and K.M. Vaidyanathan, both from Thanjavur Bani. Further, he was highly influenced by Palghat Maniyar, whom he considered as a role model, and came up with a unique style which later emerged as a Bani with lot of branches and leaves. These are just two examples. There can be more. One thing is sure, almost all our successful masters, be it Raghu sir, Shivaraman sir, Shankaran sir, and other masters in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, and Andhra Pradesh, has developed their own signature styles by getting influenced by other schools, also by their self-improvisation and innovation. Now the last question. Can someone create a new Bani? I would say no, but yes, you can create your own style. The style need to get acceptance and need to emerge as a big tree with lot of branches and leaves. Can you imagine a tree without branches and leaves? Thank you. To get regular updates from this channel, click subscribe and then click the bell icon. If you want any specific topics to be included in my visual story series, drop an email to sunilsays@gmail.com.